Welcome to the third episode of Pipe Organs of NYC, a series of virtual organ tours sponsored by the New York City chapter of the American Guild of Organists. My name is James Wetzel, and I'm the chapter's subdean and your host. In this episode, we visit the Cathedral Church of St. John the Divine, the cathedral of the Episcopal Diocese of New York. Bishop Henry Codman Potter laid the cornerstone of the cathedral on St. John's Day, December 27, 1892. He also founded the Cathedral Choir School in 1901, then a boarding school for boy choristers following the English tradition, and more proximately, the similar establishment at Grace Church down Broadway. The school continues today as a co-educational day school from which students are drawn to form the cathedral's chorister program. St. John's also offers a professional mixed cathedral choir and the volunteer cathedral chorale. The initial design of the cathedral by Hines and Lafarge was in the Romanesque Byzantine style, and after George Hines died in 1907, Ralph Adams Cram was brought on as architect, and the style was altered to the new, leaf fashionable Gothic. By 1911, after much delay and expense, the choir, the crossing, and several apsidal chapels were complete. In this initial phase, Ernest M. Skinner's Opus 150 was installed, purchased through a donation of Levi Morton, the former governor of New York. Building continued through the interwar years, and the full length of St. John's nave at 601 feet was unveiled just a week before Pearl Harbor. It is essentially in this state of completion, about two-thirds, that we know the cathedral today as one of the largest churches in the world. In the early 1950s, Aeolian Skinner was contracted to build and expand the instrument to fill the now much larger space, and very few tonal changes have been made subsequently. In December of 2001, a fire broke out in the incomplete north transept that gravely damaged the organ, which at that time was undergoing a creeping restoration program. Cleaned and repaired by Quimby Pipe Organs, in conjunction with Douglas Hunt, curator, the great organ, along with the rest of the cathedral, was rededicated on November 30th, 2008, at a service for which I had the privilege to play, as I was at the time the cathedral organ scholar. The cathedral's Opus 150A is widely considered to be the masterpiece of American organ building, and its influence cannot be understated. With 151 ranks and over 8,500 pipes, the organ is noted for its raw power, an abundance of solo colors, which are on exhibition in the following performances, and of course the state trumpet above the west porch, which is one of the loudest and most powerful organ stops in the world. Most unfortunately, on Palm Sunday of 2019, the cathedral suffered another fire that once again silenced the instrument. It is awaiting restoration, and the videos that you hear in this episode were recorded before then. Throughout its history, the cathedral has welcomed countless musicians of all kinds under its roof, including annual performances by the New York Philharmonic and the Paul Winter Consort. Dr. Norman Coke Jeffcott, Alec Whiten, and Bruce Neswick number among the past directors, and Kent Tridle now heads the music department. Dr. Raymond Nagum, Associate Director of Music and Organist, and David Briggs, Artist in Resident, are featured in this episode. Finally, to note that there are several other smaller organs on the cathedral close. A pair of Skinner organs rebuilt by Aeolian Skinner in the chapels of St. Ansgar and St. James, and a 1913 Skinner in the Synod House, all of which are also awaiting restoration. Thank you for joining us for this episode. Please do find us on Facebook and continue to visit us here on YouTube for forthcoming videos in this series.